Hey guys, me Dave. It's 2/11/2021, so I'm super tired, and I'm wearing the same thing I did yesterday because I got hit super bad last night and ended up calling for help. I called a police officer. Police officer came. This was about 12:15, 12:30. Police officer came. Took me to the hospital. On the way over there, on the way down there, I was thinking, all right, everything's ruined right now. You know, I said, all my plans are ruined. My van's ruined. My credit's going to get ruined. Everything's going to get ruined because they're sending me to the hospital. The cop is super nice. You know, if I call up and tell him I'm being tortured, which I did, I told him the truth. Told him I was being tortured and all this stuff with directed energy weapons, and the lady's like, well, I don't want you to be tortured all night. Do you want me to send a police officer to take you to the hospital, get checked out? And I'm like, yes, you know. And so then he came, drove me to the hospital, stuck around for a few minutes, super nice guy. They put me in a room, and this was early, this was about 12:30, 1 o'clock in the morning. So they're like, the ER doctor, I told her the truth. I said, you may call me delusional and all this stuff, but I'm being hit with directed energy weapons. I said, you watch the news? It's all over the news. A former CIA agent was complaining about this, and I'm being hit the same way. And she didn't really have anything to say after that, but so she checked me out and all this stuff. And asked me what was wrong and all this stuff, and I told her, and then like, well, we're gonna have a mental health nurse check you out. So I'm waiting there, and then the guy came in. He's like, I want to finish registering you in, and I'm like, well, when is the mental health nurse? When is she coming? And it's like, she doesn't get here till like 8 or 9 o'clock in the morning. So I'm like, oh, great, you know. So I'm laying there waiting until 8 or 9 o'clock in the morning. And I thought for sure they were gonna throw me in the psych ward. You know, I thought they were getting everything set up to throw me in the fake psych ward and all this stuff, but they didn't do it. They didn't throw me in the psych ward. I talked to the mental health nurse. She's like, do you feel like hurting somebody, hurting yourself, any thoughts like that or anything like that? And I'm like, no. And she's like, well, I don't see the reason. I said, usually when I come down here, they lock me up, you know. She's like, I don't see any reason to lock you up. We're just not going to lock you up all the time, you know, and stuff. So they want me to contact my nurse practitioner and try some different meds and all this stuff, you know, kind of going through the process, playing the game. I did tell them the truth, you know. They called me delusional. You know, you're having delusions, and sometimes your mind can think that, you may think that somebody's doing this to you. My battery's getting low, so, you know what I mean? So I did a lot of laying around there today, and I was waiting to get out of there then. I'm like, all right, well, you know, how long is it going to take me to go home? And so I was waiting there for like an hour and a half, waiting for them to get me out of there, you know, and stuff. And I finally got out of there around noon. It was like 11:45. Got out of there, and I had my sister come and get me. She was off today, so she came and got me and took me home and all this stuff. But you know, I told them what was going on and all this stuff, and they just said that I was delusional, you know. But they didn't lock me up. They don't want me in there for some reason. Well, I mean, I can understand with the pandemic and everything else, you know, going on. But even before this pandemic and stuff, they don't want me going back there. They told me I was never going to go back there again. You know, they're like, we're trying, the last time I was in there, they were like, we're trying to prevent you from coming back here again. You know, well, tell that to these guys who like torturing the hell out of me, you know. So that's what happened. I got released. I was there for 12 hours. I got released. Now I have an appointment with my nurse practitioner on the 16th. And she's going to try to do some different meds and all this stuff, see if this stuff goes away. Well, if it doesn't go away, then obviously it's not mental illness, you know? If we keep on trying all these medications, you know? So, that's what happened last night. They sent me to the hospital, you know? They sent me there. It was coming, and they nailed me. And they got me, and I went down there last night, and I was there for 12 hours and stuff, and it happened. And that's what happened. It was coming for the last 5 months. I mean, I've been getting it so hard that, you know, it's the second time I call for help. The first time I just talked to a police officer and stuff and that, but this time they took me down there to get checked out. And they didn't do much for me. They really didn't. Hey, Max. So they didn't do a whole lot, but I was up all night. Last night, I was being tortured in the emergency room. I was being tortured the whole time. A couple times I almost went out there and said, I'm being tortured. You know, can you give me something for it, you know? I asked for Ativan again. They will not give me Ativan. They will not give me Ativan. And I talked to the public nurse. I said, you know, Ativan seems to work. Can I take that? No. No Ativan for me. They're like, it affects the brain. It does other things to the brain. It's addictive and all this stuff. They will not give me Ativan at all. Not at all. They will not give me it at all. You know, but it calms your nervous system down and all this stuff. It actually works. Well, they're not going to give it to me, you know, and stuff. So it's unreal, you know. So that's what happened. So I just thought I would do a little video. My battery's going to die, so it's just a short video. But I'm going to cut this off. I hope you guys are doing okay. And I'm back home now. And trying to survive. I don't know what to do, you know. I mean, I hate to spend a lot of money on shielding stuff that doesn't work, you know. You know, are these guys going to keep on hitting me so I call for help? Or are we going to keep on playing this game? I don't know what's going to happen. You know, but anyway, my phone's gonna die. You guys have a good night, and I'll talk to you later.